If you have ever been diagnosed with diabetes, then your medical doctor is gonna want you to have an eye exam. But what is your eye doctor looking for? And what does that mean when it comes to your eye health, your vision, and your overall systemic health? And to answer that, in this video, we're gonna review the top 5 signs and symptoms of how diabetes affects the eyes. Let's take a look. Hello and welcome, this is Dr. Alan here from the Dr. Eye Health Show, helping you learn all about the eyes, vision, and finding the best vision products. Now today, we are talking about a very important topic in eye care and overall all of healthcare because diabetes significantly affects our eyes and our overall systemic health. So if you were recently diagnosed with diabetes or maybe you have a family member or friend who is diagnosed, this is important to understand. And the reason that an eye exam is so important for anybody who is diabetic is because through the eye, that is the only way that your doctor can physically just stare at your blood vessels and see what is going on. Because ultimately, the way diabetes hurts your body is because it damages the blood vessels. So, how does diabetes affect the eyes? The first way that I wanted to mention is that of blurred vision. Now, not everybody will experience blurred vision when they are diabetic. In fact, I would say most people probably won't. And that's why having an eye exam is so important, because you may not feel like anything symptomatically is going wrong with the eye, but that doesn't mean that things aren't getting worse. But diabetes can cause blurred vision and fluctuations in your eyesight, namely because elevated levels of sugar in your bloodstream can cause an accumulation of what is called sorbitol, basically a sugar alcohol, to build up inside the lens inside of the eye. You see, inside the eyeball, we all have what is called a crystalline lens. This lens helps focus the light to the back of the eye, to the retina, so that you can see clearly. The issue is that with elevated blood sugars, this lens can begin to almost swell in a little bit of a way, but really the crystals inside start to harden and change what's called the refractive index, which basically increases or decreases the power of this lens, which can shift your refractive power or your focusing either too strong or too weak. And so then your glasses or your prescription for glasses can become either highly more nearsighted or myopic, or it can become hyperopic or farsighted. Now this usually happens for people who are recently diagnosed with diabetes or blood sugars are very much out of control. Thankfully, with diet, lifestyle modifications, and medications, as your blood sugars get down more toward normal, this lens change can go back to normal. And so if you have a sudden change in your glasses prescription, then thankfully with normalized blood sugars, that may return to normal. Which, just an FYI, if you see an eye doctor and they're concerned about that refractive change, they may not prescribe you glasses, because they know that if you get glasses made with that prescription, in 3-4 months later, you're likely gonna need a new prescription again. I myself have written lab orders and referred to medical doctors to get diabetes checked for patients because we've seen this big refractive change. But again, thankfully, if you can keep your blood sugars stable, then hopefully you won't see this type of shift. Now, blurred vision and even loss of eyesight can come from diabetes, and that's mainly because of what's called macular edema. That's where the retina in the back of the eye begins to swell, sort of like a blister. You know how you can get a blister on like your finger and it's kind of filled with a clear fluid? That's kind of like what's happening in the back of the eye. Diabetes can cause weakened blood vessels within the whole body, and when that's in the retina in the back of the eye, it can leak this clear fluid, creating a blister-like effect within the retina. And this swelling of fluid within the retina basically causes damage or a change in the architecture of the retina, and then your vision just isn't clear. Things can seem blurry and out of focus, and what stinks is that with macular edema, it can occur at any stage of diabetes. For people who are recently diagnosed or for people who have been diagnosed for 20 years, macular edema can come at any time and before any other retinal signs or changes. So this is a big thing eye doctors have to look for. And sometimes this macular edema can even occur without vision problems or vision loss. So it's something that eye doctors like myself have have to really be paying attention to. Now, while yes, blurred vision and vision changes are our number one on this list, but keep in mind again that many people don't ever experience vision loss or vision changes with diabetes, so it's super important to still get your eyes checked. Now, the second sign or symptom of how diabetes affects the eyes is seeing spots in your vision. Now, the spots that I'm referring to are not the same thing as eye floaters, which we've talked about in many other videos. And if you're seeing spots drifting around in your vision, I do encourage you to check out those other videos on eye floaters just to understand more of what could be going on. In short, what I mean by eye floaters are these little spots that kind of drift back and forth in your vision, and for most people are a normal occurrence of age, and is a buildup of proteins that are stuck inside the gel inside the back of the eye called the vitreous humor. But when it comes to somebody who is diabetic, if they suddenly experience these new spots in their vision, or these kind of floating-like disturbances in their eyesight, that may not just be an eye floater, but it could in fact mean one of the blood vessels inside the eye has burst open and is leaking blood into that gel inside the eye, and we call that a vitreous hemorrhage. Now, even though what I'm talking about is blood stuck inside the eye, funny enough, most people rarely experience or see these spots in their vision as a red or a brown color. Most people do just see them as these black floating spots. But I have had at least a few patients tell me that they think they can see this brown thing floating around. The big concern for vitreous hemorrhage is that often means there is a growth of abnormal blood vessels occurring inside the eye within the retina itself. And that can be very serious with diabetes. And that brings us to number three on our list of how diabetes affects the eyes, and that is through retinal hemorrhaging, or bleeding within the retina. That's probably the number one thing that most eye doctors are going to be observing or looking for during a diabetic eye exam. They're going to look behind a slit lamp or using different pictures to look in the back of the eye to look for subtle small outpouching and bleeding spots within the retina tissue. And when we see this bleeding or damage in the retina, we call that diabetic retinopathy. And the reason that finding diabetic retinopathy is so important is because if we're seeing damage to the blood vessels occurring because of diabetes, then we know that different levels of severity of diabetes are occurring not just in the eyes, but they're occurring in the rest of the body, especially the kidneys and potentially even the brain. But again, the scary thing is that for a lot of diabetics out there, they may not have any visual changes or notice anything going on, yet they are bleeding within the retina. And the retina doesn't have any pain sensors, so even again, this is occurring and you don't feel pain in the eye because of this. So really, a patient who is diabetic may not experience any symptoms at all, yet they are bleeding in their eyeball. Again, just stressing why diabetic eye exams are so important. Now, moving on to the fourth way that diabetes can affect the eyes, and that is through new blood vessels that can grow inside the eye, through a medical term that we call neovascularization. You see, when there's bleeding inside the retina, that means that blood is not properly getting to the tissue. That means no oxygen and other nutrients getting to the starved tissue of the retina. And when that happens, your body wants to get that nutrients to that tissue, and so it grows new blood vessels. The problem is that these new blood vessels are fragile and they break very easily. And this is one of the biggest concerns that eye doctors have when we're looking for diabetes, because if we see these irregular blood vessels growing, you're at an increased risk of really traumatic problems with the eyes. If these abnormal blood vessels grow and potentially break, they not only leak blood and fluid into the eye, but they also have a tendency to cause fibrotic scars to form. And when these fibrotic scars form inside the eye, they can lead to our fifth sign of how diabetes can affect the eye, and that is what's called a retinal detachment. Essentially, these new blood vessels form inside the eye. When they leak this fluid and this fibrous scar forms, the fibrous scar basically bunches up really tight and pulls all of the tissue of the retina off the back of the eye. And unfortunately, a retinal detachment is extremely serious, and the prognosis of recovery, even with retinal surgery, is very poor. And for many of our patients who are diabetic, either with poorly controlled blood sugar levels or have just been diabetic for a long time, if they do have these irregular blood vessels growing or they're at risk of it, your surgeon will often use a laser or use a combination of lasers and injections of medications to help control these new blood vessels from growing. If lasers do need to be used for this case in terms of diabetes, then oftentimes they're using it to burn the blood vessels, and that also burns the retina. So it can cause problems with vision loss. But again, they're doing that because they don't want the blood vessels to grow irregular and lead to something catastrophic, such as a retinal detachment. Now, the whole point of this video is not to just mention how terrible things can be for the eyes with diabetes. It is true, diabetes can be very serious when it comes to the eye, and is a big part of my education. A lot of my education as an eye doctor is about diabetes. But I hope instead this video gives you a little bit more insight of ways that diabetes can affect the eyes and how your eye doctor is going to be looking at your eye and the things that they're going to be evaluating for. And just so you have a frame of reference, at the timing of this video, it is recommended that the standard of care, if you're diabetic, you are getting at least one dilated eye exam a year, if not more, if you have more severe signs of progressive or worsening diabetic retinopathy. But probably the biggest message that I really would like people to hear is that if you are pre-diabetic, recently diagnosed as diabetic, or maybe you've been diabetic for 20 years, to know that changes in your diet, your lifestyle, as well as taking medications, there is possibility now. There's evidence for it that we can put diabetes into remission for a lot of people, especially if it's just an earlier diagnosis. And just to provide you with more useful information, I'll put links to other YouTube videos with other healthcare professionals who specialize in nutrition, diabetes, and to help you through that journey, I'll put those links in the description below that like button for you. Also, if you're not subscribed to this channel, I do encourage you to do so because we will be having some future videos all about different vitamins and nutrition about diabetes and diabetic retinopathy specifically. There's in fact a lot of good science on that topic that's just not shared across YouTube or other resources very well. And so I plan to do a full breakdown of some of that research. Either way, thank you so much for watching. Again, Dr. Allen here. Keep an eye on it, and we'll see you in the next one.